Hello fellow dog fanciers, welcome back to another video about dog shows. So I already made a beginner friendly video about dog shows and their purpose. I will leave a link in the description. I'm also planning to cover many more other topics on dog shows because there is a lot of information. But I felt like this video was something necessary to slightly touch on before I get any further with the show topics. So I'm going to talk about, are dog shows bad for dogs? And I'm also going to show you some videos on how my Whippets spend their time at shows. If you're not subscribed yet, you can do so now. And as always, any questions that you might have on Whippets and dogs, you can leave them into the comment section. Let's get into the video. So first things first, I really want to get this out of the way. Even the purest, the best of intentions and activities can be turned into something very negative and can be altered to please the human ego, because the human is capable of turning everything at their own advantage. With that said, there are black sheep wherever you go and whatever you look into. So are there show dogs around the world that have their welfare compromised? Yes, sadly. Are there working dogs that don't live the best of lives? Yes. And are there simply four-legged companions that go through abuse? Yes, it's very unfortunate, but that is the fact. There are bad people out there that cause very bad things to their pets. But is it the sport to blame, or is it the rotten apples in it? On top of all, I feel like nowadays we're very, very quick to label something as wrong or cruel. If you look at those cute puppy compilation videos, there will always be that one person, at least one, who really wants to point out something that is wrong. But in any case, no one should ever compromise the welfare of their pets for fame, profit, or whatever excuse there is under the sun. So now that this is out of the way, there is a lot of focus and fingers pointed at the world of dog shows and show dogs. So let's go through some of the key points that people like to use for pointing at dog shows being not so good. Dogs spend their whole lives in crates and while traveling. While there might be some crate time involved at shows, usually shows happen during the weekend and dogs are free to express natural behavior and be free for the rest of the time. Are there dogs that are crated full time? Yes. Is it okay? No. Is it the sport to blame? No, it's the people that don't respect their dog's well-being. There are dogs that are being crated at home during the day or night when their owner is not around to supervise for safety purposes. This is not abuse, it's called responsibility, and it's completely fine as long as your dog gets enough exercise and attention for the rest of the time. The next key point is that show dogs are constantly being groomed and brushed. Well, definitely not constantly, but yes, there is a certain coat preparation that long-haired dogs should go through before a show. And by the way, anyone with a long-coated dog, being purebred or not, should brush their dog on a regular basis. Because there is a very big problem with situations like these. This is what happens when you don't brush your dog often enough, or when you don't take it to the groomer often enough. And to take care of that long coat properly, your dog should learn to stand still for certain intervals of time, which is actually a matter of discipline, maintenance and care. Nothing wrong with it, the opposite is very wrong. And by the way, I'm very glad that Whippets don't have long coat. The next one is, show dogs are stressed. A timid dog will rarely get awarded at shows. In most cases, you will witness well-trained, well-behaved, well-socialized, outgoing dogs. Show dogs are very used to the whole atmosphere, including the people, the noise, the other dogs, and everything that goes with it. Many of them also love to work for their handler very much, and they're very willing to please, so a few minutes of ring time is nothing for them, and on top of all, they get a bunch of treats. But to achieve that, owners, handlers and trainers, and their dogs included, put a lot of effort into training time. And this is only positive because dogs are not made to be full-time couch potatoes. They need some kind of purpose, a task, some work to do, and ring training is one way to achieve that. And I saved the best for last because it really is my favorite and really makes me roll my eyes. Dog shows and purebred dog breeding adds up to dogs in shelters. Now, bad breeding, responsible breeding, recognizing a good breeder are all topics that really deserve their own video. But generally speaking, responsible breeders of purebred dogs spend a lot of money, time, effort into gaining knowledge and finding the best possible homes for their puppies. They also ensure that whatever happens to this puppy, no matter if it's 5 months old or 15 years old, it will always have a forever home with their breeder. A dog bred by a person like this will not end up in a shelter. Regarding dogs in shelters, I always say that if someone doesn't care about breed and proof of breed, they should really consider adoption. But those who want a breed with specific traits, a health background and a proof of parentage should never be pushed to feel guilty for having that preference. Regardless, I find no excuse for buying a dog from a backyard breeder or a puppy mill. When you do that, you really add up to dogs in shelters and you support a dirty business of someone who has no knowledge. So these are a few key points. Things are way more complicated than that, but I still want to sustain the videos at a very beginner-friendly level. Let me now show you how my Whippets spend their time at shows. These videos are from the past weekend where Jamie and Ivy made me very, very proud. These were outdoor shows with plenty of space to place a tent. We do not really use crates because the girls are never left unsupervised. There is always someone to stay with them and they're behaving very, very well. There are blankets for them if it gets too cold, because on Saturday the show was in the evening, and we also have cooling towels to cool them down when it's too hot like it was on Sunday. There are pillows, fresh water, food and snacks for them whenever they want some. But they spend most of their time sleeping because that's what Whippets do best, and because also they feel very comfortable. The fence also allows them to have safe contact with other dogs and people, and this is very nice because social contact is very important. And we also sit close to the ring because they really like to watch. And Ruby was of course extremely busy hunting flies because that is always a mission and a must. They also had their very first night at the hotel. I kind of regret that I didn't really film that, but I was so exhausted that I completely switched off. And even though they're still 3 months old, mentally they behaved so well, they were polite, and everything went without any issues. So that was it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed and I hope you learned something new. I just wanted to mention this because it's important to me and I kind of forget most of the time. If you want me to make a specific video on a Whippet dog animal related topic, whatever it is, you can always let me know in the comment section, because I have a very long list of videos that I want to make and that I have scheduled in, but I'm always going to respect someone's request. So don't hesitate to do that if you want to see something specific. So that was it for me for today. As always, have a wonderful weekend and even better and easier week after that. And I will see you next Friday with a new video. Bye-bye!